My name is Raph Hamers. I'm a senior clinical scientist at the Egmont Oxford Clinical Research Unit. I'm based in Jakarta, Indonesia, and my work is on clinical trials. So the main challenges of doing clinical trials in Indonesia is that clinical trials require a high level of expertise and specific skill sets. I think in Indonesia, some institutions have that capacity, but in general, I would say there's a lot, there's still a need to invest and to develop that capacity. The importance of doing clinical trials is that it can really help Indonesians to advance healthcare and advance outcomes of patients. We're currently running a phase 3 clinical trial in adult patients with HIV infection that have tuberculous meningitis. The aim of the trial is to evaluate if the addition of an anti-inflammatory drug, dexamethasone, helps to improve the outcome of patients with tuberculous meningitis. Tuberculous meningitis is a complication of tuberculosis, and it's the most severe form. And people with that form of meningitis often die, and if you survive, you usually have severe neurological disabilities. In Jakarta, we recently established a new laboratory. It is called the Universities of Indonesia and Oxford Clinical Research Laboratory, denoted IOCRL. And the aim of the new laboratory is to really expand the agenda on clinical research. So we seek, in collaboration with our partners, to develop new lines of research in infectious diseases that are important to public health. We aim to train young scientists to develop specific skill sets to do the trials. We will have a laboratory. The laboratory will serve to do all the lab testing for clinical trials. And I think that new capacity is important to strengthen clinical research in Indonesia. The Oxford unit in Jakarta has, let's say, three themes of research. Historically, the focus has been on malaria research. So this line of research is led by Professor Kevin Beard and has focused on clinical trials mostly on the treatment and diagnosis of Plasmodium vivax malaria. A second line of research is on geospatial epidemiology, led by Dr. Iqbal Ilyazar, and his team are using big data approaches to see how they can map infectious diseases in Indonesia and correlate that to factors that determine the burdens. And the most recent line of research is clinical research, and that's under my responsibility. In that line of research, we focus on CNS infections. So the clinical trial on tuberculous meningitis is one example. It's currently, let's say, our most important project. I think the strength of our unit is that we work very closely with our local partners. So we identify the topics we work on based on their advice and based on our mutual interests. So I think that's a very strong component of our work. There are a lot of good people with great ideas. They are well trained. They great professionals to work with. What surprised me is that there seems to be a lack of collaboration. So people are working very independently, but are not necessarily sharing ideas and sharing efforts or collaborating to the extent they could be. And I think there's a great opportunity there. People can find each other more often. The projects they do and the ideas they have could have more impact. Yeah, so our research is important because of our location primarily. Indonesia is a very populous country. It's in fact the fourth most populous country in the world, and it has a huge burden of infectious diseases. Every year there are estimates of more than 1 million new TB cases, more than 1 million new malaria cases. The HIV epidemic is growing at a fast rate. It's estimated that in 2016 there were 48,000 new infections. And in addition to that, there are many, like a whole range of other infectious diseases that are still very common. So there's a lot to do. Nonetheless, I think that Indonesia is one of those countries that are underrepresented in the international discussions. So the voice of Indonesia is generally not well represented in global health and medical science. So I think there's a great need for investments in research to really advance the healthcare situation in the country. I look at translational medicine as really generating scientific data that can be used directly to improve patient care. So in the model that we use mostly is that we have a focus on patient-centered research, clinical trials. So by generating that kind of information, it also allows us to dive deeper and use those data to unravel biological mechanisms, and combining that more mechanistic information with clinical data, I think it's a very powerful model to advance healthcare. And I think that is, to me, that is translational medicine.